Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of This Week in Jewish History. We're going to go without the video of myself talking this week because I'm recording it at home and, you know, I'm just relaxing here, chilling. So this week marks the conclusion of the Fourth Lateran Council of 1215, a very important church council that had a tremendous amount of impact on Jewish history in particular. It was convened by Pope Innocent III and had a very large agenda, but there were a couple of things on the agenda that specifically related to Jews, and that's what we're going to look at today. Perhaps the most famous is the inclusion of the idea of a Jewish badge in the council, which was duly approved. For most of Jewish history, this was the most common badge, the round symbol called the ruel. But we also see several other variants, like, for example, the two tablets of the law shown on the individuals on the left there. And, of course, we have the modern equivalent, the Star of David, that is a Nazi innovation. But we talk about this in a previous lecture, so we're going to skip past it and go to the idea of transubstantiation, which was certainly the most significant element of the Fourth Lateran Council vis-a-vis Christian theology. And the council specifically confirmed a theological position that said that the communion wafers used during the Catholic Mass, shown here, held by a priest, actually, on a mystical level, in ways that I'm certainly unqualified to speak about, encompass the body or become the body of Jesus himself, and the consumption of this wafer is therefore of very high significance. So that's an entirely different topic, but the way it relates to Judaism is that it created an entirely new industry of anti-Semitic accusations, so-called host accusations or desecration of the host accusations. The name of that wafer consumed by Catholics during the Mass is called the host, I guess because it's the host of the body of Jesus. And so the argument went that if the host represents the body of Jesus, then just like the ritual murder charges that were first advanced seriously in the 12th century, were expanded in the 13th century to say that Jews somehow wanted to abuse the host for religious reasons. Of course, there's absolutely no truth to that, no matter what people say in the comments underneath this video, but let's have a look at the images, for example. This is a sort of a broadside cartoon that describes a desecration of the host accusation from Passau, Germany. And you can see here, this is basically the way the story goes. I apologize for the pixelation. But there's usually a Christian involved who's shown here sneaking into the church. He's looking over his right shoulder, and with his left hand, he is scooping up the host wafers to put into his bag. He later then goes to the synagogue where he meets with some Jews. You can barely see the ruel on the two figures on the right, and they offer him money for the host wafers that he has stolen. They then take these back to their synagogue, as the story goes, and they torture them. In this particular image, you can see the figure on the right is stabbing one of the host wafers, and blood is actually dripping from it. It's one of the miracles that that Christians will discuss sometimes to support the idea that the host actually does undergo transubstantiation. In the background, you can see the two tablets of the law with some gibberish in the original. You can see that the author of this image really didn't know any Hebrew. But at any rate, they torture the host, and then there's some suspicious noises, so people come to the door and say, what's going on there? The Jews try to collect up the wafers, and they throw them into the oven. And again, it's difficult with the pixelation here, but what's happening is, miraculously inside the flames, there's the figure of a small child that appears, and doves fly out of the smoke where they are caught by waiting angels. Again, all these miracles are used to support the idea, or these stories and miracles are used to support the idea of transubstantiation. The Jews happen to be on the wrong end of the story for our purposes. Up until this point, most of this is completely fabricated, but the latter points, unfortunately, often happened. People would break into the synagogue, arrest the Jews, behead some of them, torture others over the flames, set them alight. And the Christian shown here, who originally sold the wafers to the Jews, would also be taken away for punishment, and ultimately the synagogue would be rededicated as a church. So that's basically the story of the desecration of the host. We see hundreds of examples of this through the second millennium and of the Common Era, and it's an unfortunately very dark day in Jewish history when the Fourth Lateran Council passed this idea of transubstantiation. Okay, that's about it. I hope you have an excellent week. Thank you for listening.